What's up, everyone? This is Barbell, and welcome to my Let's Play of the brand new Doom game. Do you feel that hype? I feel it. This is going to be a good time. Now, before we get started, real quick, I just wanted to let you know that this is going to be a blind Let's Play, except for the first two maps. I'll explain why a little bit later. But a blind Let's Play just means that I have not played this game before, once again, excluding the first two maps, and I've gone out of my way to avoid all content about this game, things like screenshots, general information, and videos. So everything you see here will be my fresh first reaction. So hope you guys enjoy this. Let's go ahead and jump right in. New slot. Let's see, settings. Let's make sure it's saved everything. Okay, we'll switch that difficulty for damn sure. Crosshair? Ugh! Get that junk out of here. We don't like no crosshair up in here. We like our screen to be crisp and clean. I don't know about you guys, but crosshairs actually bother me because I feel like it takes up valuable space on the screen that I could use to just look at things. I don't know. I think everything else is all right. We'll change the difficulty when we actually start the game. All right. Which, by the way, graphics are on ultra. Am I in the wrong spot for that? There we go. Ultra graphics. So we'll see how this brand new computer holds up to this brand new game. A lot of brand new going on recently. Have you noticed that? I've noticed it. All right, start new campaign. I'm too young to die. Does anyone ever play on this difficulty? I'm curious. I don't think anyone does. Because I feel like it'd just be too embarrassing. The world would somehow know if you choose this difficulty. It's like, you're choosing I'm too young to die in a Doom game? Are you for serious? So don't be that guy. Hurt me plenty. That's kind of like normal. And in ultra violence, that's what we're going to play on. Because the higher difficulties are apparently locked until, I guess, you beat the game the first time. Which, I just want to say, that really bothers me when games lock the highest difficulty behind, I don't know, I guess a wall where you have to beat the game first. I don't know, I like choosing the highest difficulty right out the gate. Anyway, we're just going to have to settle for ultra violence. The higher difficulties are apparently locked until I guess you beat the game the first time. We're just going to settle for ultra violence.
Dumbass motherfucker.
There's been a hypening. Can you feel it? Oh, I feel it. Press space to continue. Get it? We're in space! Okay, that's probably not related at all, just a coincidence. Oh, let me read this. So you walk eternally through the Shadow Realms. Ooh, Mortal Kombat? Standing against evil, where all others falter. May your thirst for retribution never quench. May the blood on your sword never dry. And may we never need you again. Korax entry 717. Let's go.
They are rage.
Are they?
Brutal. Without mercy. But you. You will be worse. Rip and tear. Until it is done.
Dude, sounded like Palpatine up in here. Until it is done. Do it. Getting some strong Outlast whistleblower vibes from this predicament we found ourselves in. Not counting the zombies. I just mean waking up butt naked on a table. Bad memories. Alright, so I'll go ahead and explain why the first two maps are not completely blind. I actually recorded two episodes of this before. And then, after I replayed them to check and make sure everything was okay, I found out there were audio issues, so I'm having to re-record them. I apologize about that, but the audio issues should be fixed now. The problem was you couldn't hear the guns. The music and the vocals, I guess? The dialogue, there we go. You could hear just fine, but the guns were completely drowned out. It was weird. And it was because of my headset. I have a surround sound headset, and I was playing in surround sound mode, and that was the problem. So there's some sort of weird... So as you can see, there was a ritual going on. And this is where the Doom guy was located. And if you guys saw, there was a cover on it, so it was like a sarcophagus of sorts. I don't see anything else. Let's proceed for power armor. Oh, I feel that power. Whoa, that Mass Effect beacon vibe going on right now. And I understood just about as much as I did in Mass Effect when the beacon was touched. Just a bunch of mumbo jumbo. Let's put this helmet on. Feels good. And it's calibrated. I love how it says demonic invasion in progress. Like, that's programmed in for the computer to detect. Well, there's demons roaming around the base. Better send everyone an email real quick, like. Just be like, yo, demons, watch your booties.
Cannot determine the cause of the demonic invasion until the Rezov satellite is brought back.
It sounds so routine. Like, has this happened before? As far as I'm aware, this is supposed to be like a reboot of the series.
Welcome. I'm Dr. Samuel Hayden. I'm the head of this facility. I think we can work together and resolve this problem in a way that benefits us both.
Fuck you. Okay, we've got a skull just chilling on the end table here. No big deal, can we shoot it? Launch that skull. Oh, we got more skull. Oh, my skulls! They're everywhere. And we got... Well, skull with an eye still inside of it. Okay, that's the advanced skull. Oh, he's still got power armor on, too? How? How did they do this to this guy? Also, his head is freaking gigantic. But how did they do that to this guy, but his power armor remained intact? That's some careful skinning. I have to credit it to the zombies, or give credit to the zombies. Speaking of zombies. Glory kills. Dealing damage to the demons will cause them to stagger, which is indicated by a blue highlight. Move into close range, and when the highlight turns orange, press F to perform a glory kill. Attack demons from any angle, including from above, to perform different glory kills. Glory killing demons will always drop health. Oh, word? Let's go. Get kidney punched. Now, once again, I apologize for the non-blind let's play of the first two maps. I was really angry when I found the audio problem because that soiled it! Soiled it, but there's nothing I can do now, so let's just proceed on through. And I'll let you guys know once I reach the point where I haven't played. I guess if there's any silver lining to this problem that I encountered, it's that... Also, shotgun, by the way. That's tasty. If there's any silver lining, it's that... I've got a better grasp of the game concepts, so it won't be as painful to watch in these early stages. Ugh! That bad breath!
Demonic presence at unsafe levels.
That dude hit me in the face. So that's this game's version of the Imp. Definitely a lot different from Doom 1 and 2 and Doom 3. But I'm cool with it. Also, I'm cool with that barrel blowing up. Ooh, achievement! I don't know if you guys can see that. Timing is everything. I'm guessing it's get a certain amount of kills with an explosive barrel. Alright. So I think this is called a gore nest. Yes. Alright. So we got our first action sequence and I'm failing miserably. Let's back up, get a better advantage. Come in here! Come into my dojo! Do they not like my dojo? Oh! This guy likes it and he's dead. Ow. Ow. Oh. Oh lord, give me the help. Oh please, help, please! Okay, they were bum rushing me quite literally for my bum. They wanted the booty, but I said they can't have it. The booty is mine and it belongs to me. Get the health, all right. Let's look around what we got. You're mine. Who's next? Ooh, armor shards. Hopefully the armor in this game is way more effective than Doom 3. Oh, you're hanging on the wall like a spider monkey? Wow, that actually hit him. Explosive barrels have that radius. Oh, we got more dudes. Holy imps! They're everywhere! Get back here. Ooh! Held my shotgun sideways for that one, because that was a kill shot! It was a kill shot! Oh, that was brutal. That reminds me of, like, King Kong. The King Kong movie where, when King Kong faced off against the T-Rexes and he kind of did a similar move with one of them. Apparently that imp had some shotgun shells in his back pocket. Don't mind if I do. Let's retreat, make him think we're running away, but then... Oh! He knew. He knew the whole time. Alright, so if you guys are unaware... This pistol has a charge shot function. If you look at the bottom of the pistol, when I hold right click, you see all those things pop out? Now watch it longer. Boom. Blue mist. I hope you guys can see the mist. But that means the charge shot is ready and boom. And it's just a more powerful version of the regular shot. I kind of like that. I have a feeling they did that because they wanted to keep the pistol at least somewhat relevant. So I can respect that. Any secrets on this map? Excuse me. I don't know. Says there's three, plus an elite guard, plus field drones. I guess we'll find those when we find them. Hopefully. Oh, fair warning now. I'm not going to find all the secrets in this game, nor am I going to try to. I will try to find some secrets, I'll tell you that. But I acknowledge the fact that some will go unfound. That's fine. I hope it doesn't bother you. Because I don't want to spend forever looking for secrets. I want to keep things moving. But I will try to find some. So, a happy medium.
He cannot be allowed to leave this place. He will ruin everything.
Would I? So Olivia Pierce appears to be a problem. Full ammo. Alright, let's get on in here.
I'm willing to take full responsibility for the horrible events of the last 24 hours, but you must understand. Our interest in their world was purely for the betterment of mankind.
How'd that turn out for mankind? Not so good.
But it was worth the risk. I assure you.
Ooh, that intro. Ooh! Ooh, the music! Ooh! Ooh, that's good. Oh! Oh, followed by the shotgun pump. Oh Lord, my heart can't take it. That was probably one of the most, if not the most badass intro scene or sequence I've ever witnessed. That was well handled. Oh. Well, I guess we're out here for good now. Look at this welcoming Mars environment. Jump! Impact compensation. Followed by armor shards. Don't mind if I do. So here's something funny I kind of realized earlier today. There's been four Doom games. So Doom, Doom 2, the original Doom and Doom 2, and then Doom 3, and then this new Doom. And three of the four all tell the same exact story. The first Doom, Doom 3, which was like a reimagining of the first Doom, and then this Doom, which is a reimagining of the first Doom also. Codex Entry acquired. So basically we've had four Doom games and three of them are the same exact story. We've only had one extension of the story and that's Doom 2. Kind of funny. So let's see, a brief history. This is a lot of reading and like I said, I want to keep things moving. So what I'll do is I'll just kind of keep this up on the screen for a minute. If you guys want to read it, feel free to pause the video. Okay, and we're good. Oh, we got a database. Okay, so it's got info on all the stuff. Basically, Gornests, the Zambambly Boobilies, or the Possessed, as they're called in this game, they take human bodies and they like start just shoving them in the middle of the room, and eventually one of those Gornests forms. And then, I guess whenever you take the Gornest out, a bunch of dudes teleport in. So that's the short version. Now we got the shotgun and the pistol. Oh, what the hell? Yo! We got kill stats! I love stats. I actually didn't know this was in the game, so I'm very happy about that. Okay, we got artifacts. Doom Marine. This is something that's interesting. I actually want to read this out loud because it's something that's pretty cool. Additional relics were found in the tomb alongside the Doom Marine. So the Doom Marine was found in the tomb. Some incantation tablets and an ancient combat suit which was given a name, the Praetor suit. So the suit and Doom Guy were found on Mars. When found, it was encased in an inscribed stone tomb. The suit was extracted from the rock, cleaned, and subjected to numerous tolerance tests, and found to be almost impervious to any damage. Oh really? I wasn't feeling that impervious to any damage a second ago. Anyway, it appeared to have some mechanical function as well. Small receptors on the gloves and chest plate that attracted argent plasma and dissipated it through capillary tubes in the substructure. Holy grammar. Or holy vocabulary. Markings on the armor were also consistent with images of a man or humanoid seen in several of the tablets and stones found on other expeditions. The same markings were also noted on the Helix Stone. I don't know what the Helix Stone is yet. Despite it being clear that the suit can be activated in some way, no method has been found to do it. It appears to be missing a component, likely the Doom Marine himself. So how about that? The Doom Marine was found on Mars. Pretty interesting. And that's that. Real quick, the suit can be upgraded and weapons can be upgraded. I think it explains the weapon and suit upgrade tokens later, so let's go ahead and move on beyond that. Any explosive barrels? You know what? I'm gonna take the Obi-Wan approach and keep the high ground over here. That arm's mine now. Whoa. Oh, oh, barrel! Oh! Oh shit, oh shit! We got soldiers. He dead. Just keep moving. Imp's like, oh shit, Doom Guy's on a massacre, run! That imp knows. He respects my authority. No one else does, apparently. Not even the Zambambos. Oh shit, they got charge shots. They got power blasts. And you see that dude just like shooting straight up in the air. He's like, yeah, I got a gun. I'm gonna use it. Even if I'm not aiming with it, I'm gonna do it. Oh, I want that armor. Mine. Whoops, didn't mean to stun that zombie, but I'll take the glory kill. I'll take that arm too. So far, I have two arms just shoved into my back pocket. I wonder how many I'm going to end the game with. Let's get some use out of the pistol. Get out of the way, barrel! Oh shit, he's charging. He's firing his laser. Ooh, armor shards. Alright. Where is Therese from? Shit. I goofed that. By the way, I think there's a little cooldown on the charge shot before you can fire another one. Just keep that in mind. Where are the imps at? These slippery buggers? Where are you? Oh. You're a soldier. Oh, there we go. Oh, he's firing his laser again. Oh! That point blank shotgun, though. Still got combat music. Never mind. Checkpoint reached. Not bad. See, the thing that sucks is I think it's pretty obvious I've played through this already, this first map here. So that's unfortunate. But like I said, there's nothing I can do. There was an audio problem, but hopefully it's fixed now. What is that? Is that a can of soda? Or is that beer? Oh, no, stop! Stop! Mystical anti-gravity beer. I must read your name. Or is it my big-ass clown shoes knocking it around? What's it say? Something light? Dread light? I seriously can't read it. I don't know. Print's too small. Alright, any more armor shards before we proceed? I don't think so. Oh, another can of anti-gravity beer. Alright. Blue key! Oh yeah, they kept the blue key and the red key and the yellow key from the original games. I love that. Give me that. It's my. Is he missing both his arms? Really? Oh. Oh man. Whoa, whoa, wait a minute. Hold up. Look on his forehead right there. You see that, it's like the same symbol from the Faith in Game of Thrones. The Faith Militant. That's bad news, bears. They're gonna come at me with like chains and maces and shit. Also, secret up here. That's a little doom guy.
Yeah.
I like that. Extras unlocked. Combat shotgun model. Blue guy. Tab tutorial. There are two UAC Marine Guy collectibles in every map. Each one you find will unlock a model that can be viewed by visiting the collectibles menu. See if you can find them all. Gotta catch them all, Doom Guy! The collectibles menu can be viewed after selecting your campaign save slot. Close. That's pretty cool. Yes, I know where the secrets are on this map. So... because what I did is I went back and I played through this map again when I was doing testing to figure out how the hell to fix the audio problem. I swear I'm not lying about this being a blind Let's Play. I'm super serial. It's gonna be blind. I'll let you guys know when I have when I've reached a point that I haven't played past. Merry Christmas. Toasty. So we picked up a grenade there. If you guys look to the left of where my shotgun ammo count is, you guys see a little grenade symbol that appears to be recharging. That's because grenades count as equipment in this game, and equipment can recharge. There's not like a limited use, it's just a time thing. I'm gonna wait for the grenade to recharge so we can take out these zambambly boobilies in one fell swoop. Oh, we're swooping. Get swooped. Nice. What happens to the bodies? Really? Okay, I'm actually surprised about that. If I remember correctly, that was a gripe from Doom 3, that the corpses kind of teleported back to hell. I'm very surprised they kept that in. They did, didn't they? Yeah, oh, who's firing blasts? Well, now you're teleporting back to hell. That's what you get, you jerk. Checkpoint reached. Alright, so let's swoop on up here and grab the elite guard. Whoa, lost your head, eh, buddy? I'm so funny and original. Man, there's so many satisfying crunches in this game. That Captain Crunch, though. Go and grab this. This is called the auto map. Now, what the auto map does is it shows you the full map and it shows what you have and haven't explored. So all the blue areas is what we've explored. It also shows you the secrets you've found. And I think if you're within a certain radius, it'll also show you the secrets you haven't found. It'll be gray. And yeah, the gray areas is where you haven't been yet. So let's actually... oh, armor. Nice. Let's actually test that out. The elite guard is over here, right there. You see him lying up against the wall? Yeah, see how I'm close enough to where it'll show it on the mini-map, but it's grayed out because I haven't found it yet. So let's pick this up. Mine! Now, elite guards give you suit upgrade tokens. Let's check out what we got here. Environmental resistance. Decrease explosive barrel and environmental damage taken. Sorry, I don't know why I like to extend out environmental like that. I'm sure it pisses some people off when I do that. There's times where I intentionally, like, mispronounce words like melee. I call it melee. I don't know why, just for the hell of it. Debris? Instead of debris, debris? There's a lot of debris over there. It just cracks me up. Okay, so the auto map reveals exploration items in a wider radius around your position. So that's what I was talking about. It does it by default, but then this perk will allow it to be in a wider radius. Decreased recharge duration for your equipment. It's pretty cool. Cost 2 suit tokens though, so might hold off on that. Power up effectiveness. Oop, we're not allowed. It's beeping, it's booping. We're not powerful enough yet. And we need to acquire 4 weapons to unlock these upgrades. For dexterity, interesting. Okay. I guess we can look at the weapons one even though we can't. Decreases the time it takes to power up a charged energy shot. I actually didn't look at these when I played the game the first time, so these are actually new to me. Decreases the recovery time for the pistol after using a charged energy shot. Move its full speed when using the charged energy shot. Interesting. And we cannot look at anything for the shotgun yet. It's too special. It's too secret. We need a higher security clearance. Elite guard. So they were security personnel charged with protecting the Lazarus Project research, which I guess is the project that went completely wrong, or completely right, depending on what the project objectives were. But anyway, that's what caused these shenanigans to go down. I love the idea of referring to this demonic invasion as just shenanigans. Just some shenanigans. I think I missed. I didn't miss that. Hey, get back here! Hey, get back here! We must duel. Like Yu-Gi-Oh up in here. Oh, he's beating my ass. There was health up here, right? Oh, shit. Come up here. Come up here. Whoa! Come up here. That's the complete opposite of coming up here, you bastard! Alright, I'll come to you. Your health is now mine, as well as your checkpoint. Oh, here's some health and shotgun ammo. Don't mind if I do. Now, these doors are important. See how they're... It's kind of obvious. It's like, something's going on in this neck of the woods. Also, if you open up the auto map, you'll see that there's some sort of area inside of there. Now, what we gotta do is swiggity swooty on over here, and there's a lever. Oh, there's another word I like to mispronounce on purpose, a lever. There's a lever. Pull. Pull it! Full power! Oh yee. Now this opened up a little secret original Doom map, which is pretty cool, huh? You can have I goofed it up. Just gotta bounce and shoot. Bounce and shoot. It's like a bouncy castle, except way more violent. And with shotguns. Crunchy. Ooh, I need shotgun shells really bad. Hey! Oh, it even keeps like the 2D, what are these, sprites or whatever, where no matter what angle you look at them, they kind of follow you. It's really funny. Now, way back when the game first released, I had a friend of mine on Steam who decided to blab to me and tell me that there was a Doom secret like that, like an original Doom secret in the game. And that apparently there's one on every level. So I was not able to avoid that information. So I do know that ahead of time that there's one of those, I guess, doors on every map. So we'll have to look for those. Let me look around a little more. I want to find some shotgun shells. There might be some back here. Let's get up there. Which, by the way, the shotgun shells, like, limit is 20, which seems kind of goofy. Very small number. You know what? Forget it. There's probably going to be more up ahead. We got the pistol. Huh! What's this? Combat support drone. Weapon modifications. User loadout scan. Displaying available modifications. Ah, can't talk. Charge burst. Hold the weapon mod to charge up. To charge up a 3-round burst with tighter spread. Or explosive shot. Hold the weapon mod to charge up an arcing explosive round. I kind of like the charge burst. Let's go with that. Purchase. Oh shit! Sorry, combat drone. Out of it. Oh, I don't have enough ammo to try it. Oh, well, wouldn't you? Look at this. We got ammo. We got more ammo. We got zombies. You can have that. Oh, we got soldiers too? A lot of soldiers. Holy jeebus. Let's back up, but then advance. Oh, that's nice. Whoops, no, that was an imp. I thought that was a soldier. Oh, God. Oh, so many projectiles. It's like they want to kill me or something. I want my grenade back. I want my grenade back, grenade back, grenade back. Ribs. Come on, it takes so long! I might get that upgrade for the suit. There we go. Checkpoint reached. Oh, I didn't get hit? I'm quite surprised about that one. Okay. Oh, by the way, if you find another grenade box while your grenade is recharging, it'll instantly recharge it right on the spot for you. So that's pretty cool. But you know what? I think we're about to hit the 30-minute mark right now, so I'm just going to end the video. Thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next one for some more Doom action. Take care, everybody. Bye.